speaking at the Nokia Theater in downtown Los Angeles. You know, this venue opened 8 years ago. It has hosted some big events. Today, it is hosting two of the biggest stars in boxing, Floyd Mayweather, Manny Pacquiao. Walk the red carpet, talk with the press as they prepare for what some consider the Super Bowl of boxing. Hello, everyone watching around the world. I'm Brian Custer, and welcome once again inside the Nokia Theater here in downtown Los Angeles for what some consider the fight of the century. This is the one and only official kickoff press conference for the fight between Floyd Mayweather and Manny Pacquiao. It comes your way May 2nd from the MGM Grand in Las Vegas. You can see it on pay-per-view. There are over 600 members of the media from around the world credentialed just for this press conference. There will be no press tour, because when you have a fight of this magnitude, it sells itself. Joining me now, my co-host, Kieran Mulvaney. And, you know, by the way, once Floyd Mayweather, Manny Pacquiao make their remarks, we're going to interview both fighters. With that in mind, Kieran, what are you looking forward to most?
You know what, it might sound obvious. I'm looking forward to seeing the two guys up on the same stage, looking at each other, looking into each other's eyes. We've been talking about this fight for more than 5 years. There have been many opportunities when we thought it was going to happen. And even though we've known for a few weeks now that it's official, it's only when we get to see them up there looking at each other in the eyes that we're going to know it's actually happening.
Well, we've done a number of these press conferences and weigh-ins. And for me, one of the things I'm looking forward to most is seeing them face-to-face, the face-off. And there's something dramatic about that when fighters, especially at this competition, at this level, and as competitive as they are, when they get a chance to face off, you know, you got to keep in mind, this is basically the last time they'll see each other before fight week.
Yeah, you know what? And we could take the energy of all those events that we've done, we could put them all together, and it still wouldn't match this one. This is such a big fight. This has been building for 5 long years, and there's so much at stake. This isn't just to see who's the best welterweight in the world. This isn't just to see who's the best pound-for-pound fighter right now. At the end of the night on May the 2nd, one guy is going to walk out of the ring knowing that he is the defining, most successful fighter of his generation.
Well, when you talk about this being the fight of the century, there's a lot of work that goes into putting this kind of fight together. A couple of networks have to work together, things of that nature. We're going to talk with one gentleman who was key and instrumental in making sure that this fight comes together. Joining us now is the executive vice president and general manager of Showtime Sports, the one and only Steven Espinoza. By the way, happens to be my boss, so I'm going to be very nice to him today. How does a fight like this come together?
It really takes a cast of thousands. There really is no member of the team that can take a lot of credit. Starts with our senior executives who made this fight a priority. But really, it comes from the fighters themselves. Once Manny and Floyd made it clear they wanted this fight, none of the rest of us wanted to be the obstacle.
Steven, this is the first big fight of the social media era. A lot of people speculating constantly, day in, day out. How did you feel watching all the speculation going back and forth, knowing that these negotiations were moving forward bit by bit?
You know, it just magnifies. It exponentially increases the amount of attention with every little move. I mean, social media went crazy when the two of them just happened to be in the same arena at a Miami Heat game. That was a turning point, a pivotal point in the negotiation. But the reason why it became such a big phenomenon is that it was being reported second by second with pictures from the scene. I'm looking forward to that play out throughout this entire this promotion.
Now that you've been in it and you've been one of the key instrumental guys who helped put this fight together, there are a number of people who said, I never thought this fight would come together. Did you ever have that thought?
I can't say that I did. You know, there were a lot of obstacles along the way. And it wasn't really until that meeting at the Miami Heat game that I knew the fight would happen. After the two of them got together, they looked each other in the eyes and said, let's make this fight happen. That's when I knew it was going to happen.
I think we were all surprised that Manny Pacquiao and those guys, that was the first time they had basically met face to face.
It was. And it was certainly the first time that they had talked about the details of the fight, where they asked each other the hard questions. Do you want the fight? Do you want the fight? You know, is this true? Is that true? I heard this rumor. It cleared the air. It really paved the way for this fight to be made.
And like you said, once you've got the two fighters there and everybody's seeing the two fighters there, there's really no excuse for it not to happen when the two fighters come out of the room together and say, we both want to make this happen.
Right. And if anything, that's one of the downsides of social media and the constant media pressure is, you know, there are a lot of rumors, there are a lot of misinformation, there's a lot of things get thrown around and they become part of what is considered truth. And if not for that opportunity for the two of them to get together, clear the air, clear away all the rumors and look each other in the eye, I'm not sure the fight would have gotten made.
Well, before we wrap this up, what should we expect on May 2nd? There are a number of people who say, well, this fight should have been done 5-6 years ago. What should we expect May 2nd?
I think it's going to be a monumental event, a historic night. These guys, this has been a fight that everyone in the sport and outside the sport has been discussing for literally 5 years or more. But that also means that it's a fight that the fighters have been thinking about for 5 years or more. When you have that kind of anticipation among the fans and the fighters, you know, it's going to be a great night.
Steven Espinoza, appreciate your time. Thank you very much. We got to talk to another gentleman who was very instrumental in making sure that this fight comes together. Of course, he is the president of HBO Sports.
And he is my boss.
Absolutely. And that means you have to be very nice to him, Ken Hirschman. I'll ask you the same question we asked Steven. Did you think that this fight could be made, you know, once you started working and trying to get this thing together?
Yeah, I think that it went through, you know, the ups and downs that any negotiation goes through. We were always hopeful, but, you know, once those fighters gave us that mandate to do it, as Steven said, and as I've always maintained, nobody was going to get in the way of that happening. This is the Super Bowl of boxing, and we should be, you know, thankful it's here, and we are. We're happy to be a part of it.
Sort of changing it up a little bit, what do you think it is about each of these guys that makes them, it's not just their in-ring success, is it? It's the personalities that each of them have outside the ring that have made them the defining stars of the generation.
Yeah, I think they're the two greatest boxers of their generation. You know, they've both been in the same weight class. How, you know, often does that happen? And, you know, Floyd is, you know, undefeated and has that record and, you know, has that bigger-than-life persona out of the ring. And Manny's a worldwide superstar and a hero in his country. And, you know, he does so many things outside of the sport that made him a global, you know, representative of the community. So, you know, that just elevates everything, and it becomes a bigger event. And, you know, I think you see it today in terms of the turnout and interest in this fight and in, just in this press conference.
You know, Ken, I think there are a number of people who say, man, that's hyperbole when you say fight of the century, things of that nature. But then when you look outside and you see this crowd out there, the number of people from around the world interested in this fight, you understand, I guess you get a sense to realize how big this is really going to be on May 2nd.
Yeah, no question. I never realized until I got here today. I mean, I myself, I saw the reaction when the fight was announced. But again, when you're in your office and you're isolated in your world, you don't really get a sense of it until you come here and you walk that red carpet and you see, you know, all of those cameras and the blimp flying above, and then you realize, oh, this really is a special, special event, and it transcends boxing for sure, and will probably transcend sport.
I mean, it's quite something to see. One final question. You hear a lot, boxing is dead. So look outside, look at the crowd outside, look at the number of people who are talking about this fight. This is off the scale.
Yeah, I mean, I always took issue with that, regardless of whether this fight was happening. I think boxing is at, you know, historic proportions in terms of the amount of boxing on television, the amount of great boxing on television, the amount of great fighters there are in the world. There's never been a better time to be a boxing fan, and this just propels it even further, and this is just a sweet reward for everyone who's hung in there for all those years, and, you know, tune in May 2nd because it's going to be very special.
And furthermore, who said HBO and Showtime can't work together?
Exactly.
Look at that.
Exactly.
Ken, thank you very much for your time.
Thanks a lot.
Of course, this press conference is going to start in just a few moments. In the meantime, we're going to take you into one of the most exciting rounds that Mayweather has had in his illustrious career. Take a look back that really showcases his unique skill in fighting inside the ring.
Fighters like Sugar Ray Robinson.
Well, there's a brilliant start to round seven. The super quickness of Floyd Mayweather produces a knockdown to begin the seventh round. And if Corrales had any thought whatsoever of trying to come back and win a decision, that should put an end to that. He's lost the first six rounds. Now he's facing a two-point round in the seventh.
Mayweather now stops to recollect himself now. That's what you want to do with a puncher. He gets back on his feet. He can hurt you. Get your legs back under you, take a deep breath, and do it all over again what you did first. Corrales coming in down and just goes right into the left hook of Mayweather.
You knew coming in that Mayweather had a quickness advantage. I'm just not sure how many of us expected it to be this dramatic and this graphic. I mean, this has been a wipeout and a brilliant performance by Floyd. But you wonder if Corrales, in getting back down to 130 pounds...
Oh, no. It's been a masterful job here. This has been a job of pure boxing. Pure boxing.
So it doesn't matter which conviction anybody's in.
No, I agree with George. As much as it is a disadvantage for Corrales to have to come down to 130, it doesn't look the way this fight is going. It would make any difference at 135 or 140.
I think I have to agree with that. At any of these weights, Mayweather would be quicker and more skillful.
Right.
Corrales still has the power.
So we won't count him out yet.
No. All you got to do is get Mayweather too overconfident. Start trying to mix it up with this puncher. And Mayweather can be getting off the canvas himself.
And he's got to find a way to apply the power if he's going to change the course of the fight. And he hasn't gotten anywhere near it. Throwing an average of less than 25 punches per round.
I often say it, if you want to be a good fighter, forget about the left jab. If you want to be a great fighter, that's the best punch in boxing. Corrales has not used the jab all night.
And the second knockdown of the round for Mayweather. And the accumulated punishment by Corrales has left, or by Mayweather, has left Corrales woozy on his feet in the seventh round.
There is no three knockdown rule. There are 20 seconds left in the round.
And there's the third knockdown of the round.
Five, six.
And you cannot be saved by the bell, but it looks as though Corrales will have a chance
to
at least make it out of the round. Three knockdowns.
One of the more flawless performances by Floyd Mayweather. Keep in mind, Corrales was 33-0 at that time when Floyd gave him his first loss.
Yeah, exactly. One of the things that is so great about both Floyd Mayweather and Manny Pacquiao is they haven't just beaten the best of their era, they've dominated them. It's what Floyd did with Diego Corrales, and he's done with a lot of other fighters. It's what Manny Pacquiao has done with a lot of fighters, including Miguel Cotto, a real warrior, surely a first ballot Hall of Famer, but Manny absolutely took him apart when they met at the MGM Grand. Let's check in the final round of that fight.
How much more can Manny Pacquiao show us?
I would say you have to doubt he'll ever be great again. And Kenny Bayless looks like he's looking for a chance to stop the fight.
Yeah, he's virtually almost running into him, getting ready to get in position to stop the fight.
Pacquiao looking at Bayless now as if to say, what is the point? I have to chase and chase and chase.
He's saying, are you going to fight? Or should I stop it, is really what his motion means.
In the corner between rounds, Miguel Cotto's father, Miguel Cotto Sr., wanted to stop the fight and was talked out of it by the others in the corner, including head trainer Joe Santiago. Now Kenny Bayless does his duty.
We thought Manny Pacquiao was great. He's better than...
Absolutely impressive performance there from Manny Pacquiao. And I remember being in the arena that night, and at the end of it, the crowd was shouting, we want Floyd, we want Floyd. It took a while, but we're finally here.
Well, you know, they've had five common opponents. Of course, Miguel Cotto is one of them. Another one's Juan Manuel Marquez. In that same year, 2009, Floyd Mayweather fought Juan Manuel Marquez. Let's take a look back at round two of that fight.
18 landed punches in 31 tries, 58%, reducing Marquez to 4 out of 52, only 8%. A dominant round for Mayweather in round one, and a picture of the challenge that Marquez faces. Both fighters employing more left hooks than anything else so far. Mayweather is effective. Marquez is hunting and pecking, trying to find a way to land one.
It's like the Mark Cage is throwing those punches there. The crowd gets excited, but Floyd, particularly being that he's bigger than using his size, he just merely leans back and uses his left shoulder and his right glove, and he doesn't get hit. And that's what he does anyway, but with a smaller guy, it's even more effective.
Yeah, most of Marquez's left hooks have been easily blocked by Mayweather's right glove.
But Floyd is trying to get that left hook of his off to catch Marquez with. And if Floyd, he lands, he's going to have way more power.
Floyd is the faster fighter, obviously, so far. But they both, to me, seemed like coiled cobras. And there's tension, even though there hasn't been a lot, too much action so far, because either guy can strike just like that at any moment.
And Mayweather grins about the straight right hand, which is enough to tell you that it landed. Marquez's best punch is his straight right hand. Mayweather's is also, and there's a knockdown on a left hook. Excellent left hook, and Marquez walked right into it.
Yeah, well, I could see it coming a while back, but that's all he's been throwing at him, and he knew that sooner or later he would time him.
Marquez is in bad trouble.
We've seen him knocked down before, but not against a fighter like this. He was knocked down 3 times in the first round in his first fight with Manny Pacquiao, but then adjusted. Mayweather lands the left hook. Marquez took it well. Marquez is not ceasing aggression. He's trying to step it up. He's landed a couple good shots in this round, but of course Mayweather has scored a knockdown on the left hook.
Juan Manuel Marquez, just another one of the 47 victories for Floyd Mayweather. Both fighters are here, Floyd and Manny, finishing up some of the interviews with some of these boxing reporters. And his press conference is going to begin in just a few moments.
We saw again common opponents there. And I think the last time really that there was a fight that was as hyped, even close to this one, was when Floyd fought Oscar De La Hoya in 2007. And really, him beating Oscar De La Hoya was what turned him into a superstar. And the same thing happened with Manny Pacquiao when he met Oscar. Let's take a look at the results of that fight when Manny Pacquiao beat Oscar De La Hoya in 2008.
He is cringing in the face of Pacquiao's unstoppable onslaught. CompuBox numbers in the seventh round. De La Hoya, 7 of 24, and he threw 10 of those punches in the last 30 seconds of the round. Pacquiao, 47 of 103, including 45 of 76 power shots. David Diaz was closer to being in the fight against Pacquiao than Oscar De La Hoya is at this moment.
Harold and I both scored the last round a 10-8 round for Pacquiao.
Well, and you heard the commission doctor indicating in De La Hoya's corner that he will not be allowed to continue that kind of sustained taking punishment without the fight being stopped.
The old warrior still trying to hang in there against a man in his prime who is the most exciting little fighter in the world.
Little?
Big.
He
little
looks big
fighter.
Tonight. Pacquiao is fighting tonight in the welterweight division. The champion of this division is the almost supernaturally big welterweight, Antonio Margarito. All right, Larry, you envisioned this one. Could you see Pacquiao against Margarito?
No, and he himself says he's going back to 140 after this fight. This could be the end of the fight here.
Yeah, Oscar has no defense at all. His body language is, and he doesn't know what to do. who doesn't know what to do at all.
Well, all good things come to an end. Watching this, you wonder if you'll ever see Oscar De La Hoya near the top of the sport again. It could be that the long and glorious run of the Golden Boy is seeing the curtain drawn here tonight.
Death by a thousand left hands.
And if in fact the Golden Boy is being dethroned, it's happening at the hands of the fighter who may have the best chance of picking up his identity as the economic bell cow of the sport. Because Pacquiao's following is growing, not just in the Pacific Rim, but in the United States and Latin America as well. Tony Weeks has a tough decision in front of him. There's a lot of glory and a lot of money in Oscar De La Hoya.
Great example there of Manny Pacquiao's combination of blistering speed and power, and that's certainly what his fans are going to hope to see on May the 2nd.
Well, on May 2nd, of course, they're calling this the biggest payday in sports. There's no other sporting event that has generated the type of money that they expect that this fight to generate. Keep in mind, you just saw Oscar De La Hoya, Manny Pacquiao. When Floyd Mayweather fought Oscar De La Hoya, it set so many box office records, especially when you talk about pay-per-view buys, 2.48 million pay-per-view buys for that. Bob Arum says he expects this fight to do 3 to 4 million. And when you think about that, that fight, Oscar De La Hoya, Floyd Mayweather, generated 150 million. They expect this fight to generate $300 million.
That's going to be an awful lot more money than I'm going to be making covering this fight. But that's what happens when you get to the top of the game. And honestly, it's worked out well for them in some respects to get the tension going and the anticipation going over 5 years.
Well, and one of the things that I thought was interesting, you look at Floyd Mayweather and his boxing debut, his first fight, he made $2,500 in his pro debut. He's going to be making more than $120 million, basically, for this. He's making about $2,500 a second, basically, in this fight.
I remember talking to one of the Las Vegas fight writers who covered that debut and some of Floyd's very early fights, and remember going back into the dressing room afterwards and going, Floyd, who's about 3 or 4-0 at that stage, who do you want next? And already Floyd was going, Oscar De La Hoya, man, I can beat Oscar De La Hoya right now. That's an example of the kind of ambition that he's had.
And, you know, again, this is a fight that both of these fighters have always wanted to have. It's going to be very interesting to hear both their camps talk about this, but when you talk about the box office, the MGM Grand, you look at when Floyd fought Canelo Alvarez, there was over 16,000 people at the MGM Grand just from ticket sales alone, $20 million. They're expecting this to double, around the range of $40 million, basically at the box office just for tickets for this fight.
There were something like 12 or 13,000 people at the weigh-in for that fight. I thought I'd never see anything like that before. We're certainly going to see something like that and a lot more again on May the 2nd, well, the week leading up to it.
Again, as they talk about the magnitude and just how big this fight is going to be, you get a sense of just how big it is when you look at the number of people just outside this venue. And again, this is just a press conference, not open to the public, but there's so many people out there, just so many media outlets. Again, 600 media credentialed here from all over the world, from not only entertainment to news, but sports. All of them want a piece of Floyd Mayweather and Manny Pacquiao. You just get a sense of just how big this fight's going
to
be.
First of all, I'm not used to doing boxing press conferences that have red carpets. Secondly, I'm certainly not used to doing boxing press conferences where, like, my station is right next to Jimmy Kimmel's, which is right next to Entertainment Tonight's. That's the kind of scale that we're talking about.
Yeah, and again, both of these fighters are here. They were getting ready to start this press conference in just a few moments, but we wanted to give you just a sense of just how big this fight is going to be and the magnitude of it. And you got to keep in mind and remember now, a number of these belts are going to be on the line. I mean, everything will be on the line for this fight. So this is why you talk about pound for pound. Floyd, when you talk about Ring Magazine, ranked number one pound for pound fighter in the world, Manny Pacquiao number three. So you're getting two of the best right now in the ring.
Yeah, and that's, I think, an important point. We talk about the money, we talk about the fame, and we talk about, you know, how long it's taken to make the fight. But the key point is these are still, as they were back in 2010, at worst, two of the three best fighters in the world, arguably perhaps the two best fighters in the world. And how often does that happen, that number one and number two get to face off? And that's really what makes this such a significant fight.
Again, once this press conference is over, Kieran and I will both interview Floyd Mayweather and Manny Pacquiao, and it will be an interesting to see. And I can't wait for the fans to see this, too, once these guys walk inside this auditorium here at the Nokia Theater and get a chance to see each other, and their camps get a chance to see each other. I cannot wait to see that. And you know what? They don't have to wait anymore.
You know what? We've done our best. We've set everything up. They don't need to hear from us anymore. We've been waiting 5 years. The fans are ready. The media is ready. The fighters are ready. Let's get this show started.
Promoter and his trainer are in the Boxing Hall of Fame, and he is a future Hall of Fame fighter based on his record and history inside the ring. 57 victories, 38 big wins by knockout, 10 times a world champion in 8 record-setting divisions. Ladies and gentlemen, he is the fighting pride of Sarangani Province, the Philippines, presenting the two-time reigning and defending WBO welterweight champion of the world, Manny Pac Man Pacquiao!
I've been here for a very, very long time, and I know what it takes when it's a fight of this magnitude.
Hard work! Hard work!
He must know that I'm not like no other fighter. I can give it, and I can take it.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is boxing's undisputed number one attraction, the pound-for-pound superstar and the 8-time five-weight division champion of the world, introducing the undefeated, the one and only Floyd Manny Mayweather.
Tempo and jab through the guard and that right hand, and what a sublime right uppercut up the middle by Mayweather. And a double left hand by Mayweather. Mayweather remains money in Las Vegas.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, here he is, representing some of the finest boxing skills this sport has ever seen, and he is ready for the biggest challenge of his career. Recognized as the world's highest paid athlete, and for good reason. Undefeated in his 18-year campaign with a record of 47 wins, no losses, and a veteran of 25 world title appearances. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the pound-for-pound great and the pay-per-view king, the 11-time world champion in five weight divisions, the current undefeated WBC and WBA welterweight and super welterweight champion of the world, Floyd Manny Mayweather.
Hello, world. Welcome to this amazing moment in boxing and sports history. We're very excited to be making history today by officially announcing the biggest boxing event in the history of the sport and one of the biggest events ever in all of sports. Floyd Mayweather versus Manny Pacquiao, Saturday, May the 2nd, at the MGM Grand Garden Arena in Las Vegas and live on pay-per-view. First, I would like to recognize Floyd and Manny for the role they played in making this fight happen. That meeting in Miami was a major, major milestone, and I personally want to thank Floyd for making this happen. I'd like to also recognize a few individuals who played a critical role in making this great fight happen. First and foremost, I'd like to acknowledge Les Moonves, who worked tirelessly behind the scenes, out front, in making this fight happen. I'd also like to acknowledge Al Haymon, Bob Arum, Steven Espinosa, Richard Plepler, Mark Taffet, and Ken Hirschman. Also, on behalf of Floyd and Mayweather Promotions, it is an honor to be able to make Mayweather versus Pacquiao happen with some of the best in the business. Top Rank, MGM, Showtime, CBS, and HBO. This event is promoted by Mayweather Promotions and Top Rank Incorporated, and all these people are working together to make this great, great fight happen, and we're truly, truly excited. Mayweather versus Pacquiao is a tremendous fight between two great champions and two great men. May 2nd will be a spectacle like none ever seen before in the great city of Las Vegas. Over the years, Floyd has made MGM Grand his home, and they have gone above and beyond to ensure the highest quality for every Floyd event. This will be Floyd's 11th consecutive fight at the MGM Grand and the 14th time he will fight there in his career. I'm thrilled to introduce a man who I consider a great friend who has helped us get to where we are at today, none other than Richard Stern, president of MGM Resorts International.
Thank you, Leonard. Appreciate that. Good afternoon to the media in attendance and the millions of fans watching worldwide. We are thrilled that this fight has come to fruition and that it will be held at the MGM Grand. The resort is home to the biggest names in sports and entertainment, and on May 2nd, we will host one of the greatest fights in the sport has ever seen. Over the years, both Floyd and Manny have treated fans inside the MGM Grand Garden Arena and those watching on pay-per-view to a thrilling fight experience. While their previous fights have been extremely exciting, we believe there is nothing that will compare to the spectacle these two champions will deliver on May 2nd. Although the fight will take place at the MGM Grand, our entire MGM Resorts family is prepared to deliver our guests an unforgettable experience. Whether they travel from Los Angeles, Chicago, or the UK, everybody can expect service that will be second to none. I'd like to give a special thanks to all the parties involved and continue to support Las Vegas and our championship events. Heyman Boxing, Mayweather Promotions, Top Rank, Showtime Pay-Per-View, HBO Pay-Per-View, the Fighters, the Nevada State Athletic Commission, and the media. We look forward to seeing you May 2nd for an electric weekend and a tremendous championship boxing event at MGM Grand. Thank you very much.
Now I'd like to introduce our co-promoter, none other than legendary Hall of Fame promoter, Bob Arum, founder and CEO of Top Rank.
Thank you, Lennon. Hello, Floyd. It's great to be here. It's great to be part of an event that so elevates the sport of boxing. When we compare it to other events, major events, like the Super Bowl, even the Olympics, we get worldwide attention to those events. And it's been rare that that worldwide attention focuses on a boxing match. And believe me, with the help of everyone, the world, the entire world, will be watching May 2nd in the United States, May 3rd in Asia, but they'll all be watching this great event unfold. And it's a credit to the sport of boxing that we've been able to put on such an event. So I want to thank you, Leonard, for your great cooperation. It really has been great. Everybody said, hey, with the animosity, with the camps, you'll never get this done. But that's not true, because It's been seamless. Everybody's been cooperative, except for Senior over there, who's staring at me. He's my friend. He's been my friend forever, right, Floyd? Yeah. Now, we're all family. We're all part of this. We're all part of this boxing family, and we're all so proud to be able to present this event. Manny Pacquiao has been backed by HBO since the beginning of his career. The first time he came on the scene was as a substitute, when he was brought in and he won a world title in his first appearance on HBO. And since then, HBO has been behind him 100%. They've built his career, they've built his image, and they've made him the personality that the public sees today. I want to thank personally the great chairman of HBO, Richard Plepler, the head of programming, Mike Lombardo, and of course, the head of sports, Ken Hirschman, who's here with us today. So Ken, you should be very proud today that you have helped make this event possible. Ken Hirschman.
Thank you, Bob. On behalf of Richard Plepler, Mike Lombardo, and everyone at HBO, thank you for coming. This is a historic moment, and we're proud to be a part of it. Over the next few months, you know, the fans and pundits and writers will break down this fight, every aspect. You won't be able to get away from it, and we'll all enjoy that part of the process. But I want to take a brief moment to look back and appreciate how we got here. As Bob just said, it was 2001 when a young 118-pound kid out of the Philippines named Manny Pacquiao made his HBO debut. Coincidentally, Floyd Mayweather was the headliner on that card that night. Floyd made his debut earlier on HBO in 1997, and since then, he's fought on HBO or HBO pay-per-view 26 times. While these two have never shared a card again before May 2nd, they've each gone on to have Hall of Fame careers and have become the two biggest fighters of their generation. Floyd has headlined 9 HBO pay-per-view events and Manny 17. Those 26 events have compiled over 21 million pay-per-view buys and over $1 billion in revenue. And now, May 2nd, fittingly, these two superstars will participate in what we all know will be the single largest boxing event of all time. And if the turnout is any indication today, we're well on our way. HBO is synonymous with the sport of boxing's most thrilling and momentous events. May 2nd promises to be another electrifying chapter added to our portfolio, and we're proud to be involved in making history yet again on May 2nd with Mayweather and Pacquiao. Thank you very much.
I'm old, but I don't. Next up to the podium, I want to introduce a gentleman who also played a critical role in making this great fight happen. None other than the Executive Vice President and General Manager of Showtime Sports, Steven Espinosa.
Thank you, Leonard. When Floyd Mayweather signed his historic deal with Showtime and CBS 2 years ago, he promised us two things. Number one, he'd be fighting more often. And number two, each of the 6 fights under his deal would be the biggest events possible against the best opponents possible. Many people in boxing were skeptical, but fast forward 2 years as we all gather here today, and Floyd has kept every word of his promises. And now, for the second time in just 5 fights at Showtime, Floyd is fighting an opponent that many people thought he'd never fight. Showtime pay-per-view and Floyd set a pay-per-view record with the first event back in September 2013, and we look forward to another record-breaking performance on May 2nd. Showtime's been involved in some of the biggest pay-per-view events in history, including Lewis Tyson in 2002 and, of course, the all-time record, Mayweather-Canelo in 2013. But none of those events has generated the type of excitement, anticipation, and media attention that matches the hysteria that this fight has already generated. And that's one of the reasons why all of us at Showtime and CBS are so excited and so proud to be helping bring this fight together. Excited, proud, thrilled, there are countless adjectives to describe our feelings about this event. But surprised is not one of them. No, we're not at all surprised this fight was made. As soon as we closed our deal with Floyd back in 2013, the Pacquiao fight was a top priority, both for Floyd and for us. Not everyone is aware because we didn't talk about it much, but whenever it was time to discuss a Mayweather opponent, Manny Pacquiao was always high on Floyd's list. And again, that was no surprise to us. We've known for at least 5 years that Floyd has wanted the Pacquiao fight very badly. Back in 2009, I was personally involved the first time a Mayweather-Pacquiao fight was negotiated, and I not only drafted the deal memo between the parties, but also the infamous drug testing clause that was ultimately the reason why the fight didn't happen. So now here we are 5 years later with potentially the biggest and most lucrative combat sports event the world has ever seen. And so with the support of our senior executives, from Matt Blank to David Nevins and Sean McManus and David Burson, and of course Leslie Moonves, who was the catalyst for this deal, the difference maker in terms of getting this fight done after so many failed attempts in the past. As a CEO and as a longtime boxing fan, Leslie was, as Leonard said, the driving force behind the deal and a primary reason why this fight was made. We will be using the vast reach of the CBS Corporation, CBS Television Network, CBS Sports Network, Showtime, CBS Radio, CBS Interactive, to name a few, in unprecedented ways to magnify the scope and stature of this event. All of us at Showtime and CBS are proud to be bringing this event together. We're thrilled to add this event to the list of world-class sporting events brought to you by the CBS Corporation. The NCAA Men's Basketball Championship, the Masters, SEC football, NFL football on Sundays and Thursdays, Super Bowl 50, and now add to that list Mayweather versus Pacquiao on May 2nd. We know that Floyd is the consensus number one fighter in the sport. We know that Floyd is the most talked about athlete in all of sports. We know Floyd is by far the number one pay-per-view draw in the sport. And together with Floyd, Showtime pay-per-view has become the number one pay-per-view distributor in the sport as well. And now together with everyone up on this dais and everyone working behind the scenes, we look forward to breaking more records and making more history on May 2nd. Thank you.
Well, Stephen, everybody has their own opinions. You missed me, right, Floyd? I'd like to introduce the gentlemen who are sitting up here, who are part of Manny's team. First, his advisor, Michael Kahns. Michael? And seven-time Boxing Writers Association Trainer of the Year, a legend in the sport. He crosses swords on May 2nd with another legendary trainer, my good friend Floyd Mayweather Sr. Freddie Roach is an inspiration to all of us. We love Freddie dearly. And for me personally, it's a privilege to be working with him. Please welcome the trainer of Manny Pacquiao, Freddie Roach.
I'd really like to thank all the people that made this fight happen. I love challenges. This is the biggest challenge of my life. It's finally here. It's finally in front of me. I've been looking forward for this for a long, long time. I'm going to get my fighter as ready as possible. We are in the toughest fight of our life. We're fighting the best fighter in the world. And we're going to kick his ass. I'm sorry, but good luck, Floyd.
And now it's a pleasure for me to introduce to you Manny Pacquiao. Manny comes from the Philippines. Now, what does that mean? I think when we think of the Philippines, we think of a number of things. I know, growing up as a young boy, I remember the Philippines for their graciousness and kindness. I remember during the horrible time during the Holocaust, where the doors of most countries of the world were closed to those fleeing the Holocaust, including this country, the doors in the Philippines were not only open, but welcoming. And they took in thousands of refugees fleeing the Holocaust on the order of the President of the Philippines, Quezon. We know what graciousness and kindness the Filipino people show. We have to only visit a hospital in California, in Nevada. 80% of the nurses are Filipinos because they are gracious people and kind people. But I also know growing up that at the start of the Second World War, I'm old enough to remember that the Philippine troops fought side by side with the Americans against the Japanese, defending their island, Bataan, Corregidor, and other places. And when the American troops, because of lack of supplies, were forced to surrender, the Philippine troops took to the mountains and the jungles and became guerrillas and fought tooth and nail against the Japanese for 3 long years until General MacArthur came back. So we know the graciousness and kindness of the Filipinos, exemplified by this man, Manny Pacquiao, who gives fortunes away supporting charities in the Philippines, whether it's founding hospitals, schools, building churches, supplying fishermen with motors so they can increase their catches, getting out to the deep water quicker. He is legendary for graciousness and kindness. But like those Philippine warriors, he has a fierceness about him that most Filipinos have, a toughness. He is a fierce fighter who doesn't quit, who gives its all, and will bring his best on May 2nd. I present to you now the WBO welterweight champion of the world, Manny Pac Man Pacquiao.
Thank you, Bob. And I would like to thank God for giving us and providing us a wonderful day, a beautiful day, and giving us strength. And I want to thank Showtime and HBO for helping to make this fight happen, and also Mayweather team, Mayweather promotion, Top Rank promotion, and Team Pacquiao, and to all the media, to all the media and press, thank you so much to all your support, and to the fans of boxing. I think, I believe that is what are you waiting for since 5 years ago. So I think the fight is on, and you're very excited. I know you're very excited, and we're both of us. We're going to undergo a hard training for this fight, and we will do our best on May 2 to make you happy. And the most important thing is not to us, to me, or the most important thing is the name of the Lord, that the name of the Lord will be glorified. And I want to know that there is God. I want to know the people that, you know, I want to let the people know that there is God who can raise from someone from nothing into something. And that's me. That's me. I came from nothing into something. And that's, I owe everything to God. He gave me this blessing. So it's all credit to the Lord. And thank you to all the fans, especially to the Filipino people who are always supporting me. They are watching now live in TV, and some of them are here. And I would like to thank Freddie Roach for being nice to us, Team Pacquiao, being nice to me, and Bob Arum, and you know. That's what we call is our team is we have loyalty in each other, because we've been working since 2001 until now 2015, and I think we're the longest teamwork in boxing history as a coach in boxer, and also my promoter Bob Arum is my loyalist to them. So thank you for trusting me, and God bless you all.
Every great fighter has a great trainer. And I like to acknowledge none other than his father and trainer. He's one of the top trainers in the world and has been for many, many years. None other than Floyd Mayweather Sr. This next man, he really doesn't need any introduction. He's been pound for pound the best fighter in the world for many, many years. He's 47-0 with 26 knockouts. He's beat everybody in the sport. Come May 2nd, it will be no different. He's the current WBC welterweight and super welterweight champion. He's the WBA unified welterweight champion, and he's also the WBA super champion in the super welterweight division. He's averaged over 1 million pay-per-view homes every time he fights, which is the highest average ever in the history of the sport. He's been named the world's highest paid athlete by Forbes magazine, ESPN the magazine, and Sports Illustrated, which is truly a testament to his great popularity around the world. On May 2nd, he faces another great challenge in front of him, and fellow world champion Manny Pacquiao. This will be a fight the whole world has been waiting to see for quite some time. Once again, Floyd is out to only prove to the critics why he's been the best fighter, not only of this era, but many other eras. He will go out come May the 2nd, and he will show you why he's been the best, and they call him the best. And they call him the best because he goes out there and proves it every fight. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce the pound for pound best fighter on this planet, none other than Floyd Money Mayweather.
First off, I have to thank my father, unbelievable trainer, unbelievable person. You know, I want to thank Showtime, MGM Grand, so many different social media outlets, the fans, Team Pacquiao, Top Rank. It's been a long road, but we're here now. Al Haymon, remarkable guy. You know, if it wasn't for Al Haymon, my father, Leonard, and my team, I wouldn't be where I'm at today. So I want to say thank you. May 2nd, the fight of the century. It's all about the best fighting the best. And Pacquiao is one of the best fighters of this era. And everything is about timing. And you know, I think we couldn't choose a better time. You know, our game plan is just to be smart and take one fight at a time, like all 47 fights. This is a fight that the world can't miss. This is an unbelievable matchup. Action-packed fight. I'm in the gym working right now, dedicating myself to the sport, pushing myself to the limit, because I never wanted to win a fight so bad in my life. And I'm pretty sure he's gonna push himself to the limit, because he wants to win just as bad as I want. He wants to win just the same way I want to win. But one thing I do know about any sport, when you lose, it's in your mind. If you lost once, it's in your mind. If you lost twice, it's in your mind. From day one, I was always taught to be a winner. No matter what, be a winner. Push yourself to the limit. Stay focused. And be the best that you can be. Steven Espinoza, I want to thank you. Richard Stern, I want to thank you. Bob Arum, Team Pacquiao, because without everyone together, we couldn't make this fight happen. So I have to be thankful for us coming together as one so that we're able to give the world what they want to see. Mayweather Pacquiao. Everybody that's tuning in, we want to say thank you. I'm pretty sure you're going to see hashtags on Twitter, Instagram shots. May 2nd, that's when the world stops. I want everyone to tune in. Mayweather Pacquiao, the biggest fight in boxing history. Thank you.
There's been an incredible demand by everyone all over the world to attend this fight. So ticket prices will range from $1,500 to $7,500. And we'll put out an announcement in the coming days for an on-sale date. This will conclude today's press conference. Thank you for everyone for coming out.
Another photo op, please. Leonard, we need another photo op. Leonard, we're going to do another photo op, okay? Everybody,
well, there
the
you
dais,
have it.
Come down.
Both fighters have had their say. These two will take some pictures. And once they're done with that, we're going to speak with the pound for pound king in boxing, Floyd Mayweather, as well. Thought it was interesting when you heard Floyd Mayweather. Guerin said, hey, this is the fight he's wanted for a very long time.
And you know what was kind of interesting? At first, everyone's being real nice to each other. But it didn't take very long for the little digs to start coming in from both sides. And there was Floyd, who's always a master of the psychological aspects of the fighting as well as everything else, kind of pointing out at the end that he has an 0-1 his record. Manny Pacquiao's lost a couple. Just putting that little doubt there.
He's very good at that.
Yeah, I thought one thing was interesting was Manny took the diplomatic approach. You know, obviously we know he's a very spiritual guy, but yeah, I thought you hit it right on the head when Floyd said, "Hey, listen, when you've lost before, it's always on your mind." And I think that was just a little message to Manny. Listen, you've lost before. I have not. So this is uncharted territory. It's not uncharted territory for me, but not for you.
Well, I don't know. Something. Yeah, exactly. I mean, you know, but the scale and the size of it still. Both guys have been responsible for some of the biggest pay-per-views, for some of the biggest fights in recent history. And even for both these guys, this is a whole new thing. You can actually kind of feel that little element of tension there, that little element of energy and nervousness.
And again, they'll have another face-off for the media here as they take their final pictures before we conclude this press conference. And again, the WBA Super, the WBC, the WBO, the ring welterweight title, all of those will be on the line for this mega fight.
At the end of the day, of course, that's all going to be forgotten. It's all about who's number one, not just right now, but over the last 10 years or so.
And Manny Pacquiao has certainly been on a roll. He's won 3 straight fights, has looked impressive in those last 3 victories that he's had. Floyd Mayweather, by the way, in case you're wondering, 24-0 in world championship fights is Floyd Mayweather at this point in his career.
And we're looking at the whole team get together here. This was a thing that we didn't think would happen for quite some time. Not only getting the fighters together, but getting the promoters, getting the broadcasters, everyone in one shot. This kind of sort of sums up what this whole thing is all about.
I was trying to find out, you know, when was the last time Floyd Mayweather, you heard him talk about losing? Keep in mind, the last time he suffered a loss, August 2nd, 1996, it was 18 years ago, it was at the Olympics in Atlanta. That was the last time he suffered an L.
I believe even that was kind of disputed.
Yeah. So. Absolutely. Well, again, the pound-for-pound king of boxing, Floyd Money Mayweather.
Yes.
He's here. I thought it was interesting. You said this is a fight you have wanted for a long time and have wanted very much so. Explain that.
Well, you know, a lot of times you hear certain things in the media. You hear certain things from the critics, the writers. That's not true. That's totally false. We tried to make this fight happen in the past. We kept bumping heads. You know, the teams kept bumping heads because of random blood in your intestine. Then about being the A side and who's going to be the B side. So it was a lot of problems in the past. And we finally resolved everything. The teams got on the same page and we made the fight happen.
Give me the one thing for Floyd Mayweather that said, all right, let's do this fight. Put the fans' desire aside. Was there one thing? I read that there was that meeting you had in Miami. What was the one thing for you that you said, let's do this?
Well, everyone wants to keep talking about how this fight happened. This fight happened because of me. You know, this fight didn't happen because of Manny Pacquiao, because I asked for the fight myself. We had to choose an opponent for May, and I said, what better opponent to choose? And so we chose Pacquiao.
Let's talk about motivation.
Yes.
You saw the Super Bowl commercial. He mocked you in the commercial. Somehow, oh, he's been avoiding me. Now he's finally going to fight me. You heard Freddie Roach. He said he's going to kick your ass, basically. And he said that he was going to knock you out in this fight.
Uh-huh.
When you heard that, give me your motivation, especially when people say, oh, Floyd has avoided him for 5 years. Give me your take when you hear that.
I just feel like everyone is entitled to their own opinion. My job is just to be Floyd Mayweather and stay focused on the positive things. When a fight presents itself, go out there and do what I do best. Let's go out there and win and be smart.
Does it upset you when you hear that?
I don't focus on that.
Yeah?
You know, not at all. You know, I know what I can do. You know, I know what I bring to the table, and I know what I bring to the sport of boxing. You know, to be the face of boxing and to do so many record-breaking things. You know, it's all about just staying relaxed and staying focused.
My last question to you. I love it. A year ago when we were here, we talked about Marcos Maidana. You said, I'm going to be right there. And you were in that first fight. You were right there. And it surprised a lot of people. And then in the second fight we talked, you said, I'm going to make it easier. And you boxed him, and you did make it easier. What should we expect May 2nd?
May 2nd, just expect us to have a brilliant game plan and to to be the best that we can be, you know. You know, it's all about working hard in the gym, listening, being smart, knowing your body, and then when it's time to go out there, we do what we do best.
Best of luck to you May 2nd, man.
Thank you.
There it is. That's Floyd Mayweather. And joining us will be Manny Pacquiao as he talks about his game plan and what he intends to do on May 2nd.
A lot of confidence there, as expected, from Floyd Mayweather. Nice and calm, cool and collected, as always. Not surprisingly, it's a little bit of a scrum up here on the stage, but we're going to hope to try to get Manny Pacquiao right over here in just a second, and we'll see what he has to say before, but Floyd has to say from his perspective about fighting Floyd, about fighting Manny. Here's Manny. Manny Pacquiao. Manny Pacquiao joining us right now. Manny, it's been many years that we've talked about you guys meeting. Before the press conference, you stared at each other for a good long time. Did you say anything to each other?
No.
How did it feel to just be up there finally at that stage, looking at him in the eyes?
It's feel good. I'm ready. I'm as ready.
You've been in a lot of big events, obviously. This must feel even bigger. How does this feel for you in terms of an event and what it means for boxing?
This is a very important fight and big fight, and this is going to be a historic fight.
When did you know in your heart that this fight was definitely going to happen?
Last year, by November, I know that this fight will meet happen by 2015.
Was that because discussions had happened or because you felt you needed to really push it? You were very vocal after the Chris Algieri fight about making the fight happen.
Yes, I think I realized that I think it's time that I'm the one who's going to announce it or push it to make the fight happen. And it happened that coincidence and in Miami that we met together there.
How big was that meeting in Miami? It felt as if that's what pushed all the negotiations forward. Is that true?
It's helped a lot. But a big help for this fight happened is Showtime and HBO.
A lot of people had to come together. There was a lot of different things that had to be sorted out. Were you at all concerned that the negotiations would fall apart over some little detail? Or, you know, did you just put your faith in the process?
Just put the faith in process and agree what he wants to do and you know, just to make the fight happen. And I'm agree 40-60.
Final question, Manny. We've been planning, waiting for this fight for 5 years. I know you've been thinking about fighting him for 5 years. Is the game plan the same now as it would have been in 2010? Or has it changed a little bit?
It's the same. I mean, it is the same, and then more hard work in training to make sure.
And basically, what is the biggest danger that you face going up against a guy like Floyd Mayweather? He's a very good defensive fighter.
What's the biggest,
What is the biggest strength that he brings to the table that you have to overcome on May the 2nd?
He has a good defense, but I'm not worried about that. I mean, I can easily break that defense.
Manny Pacquiao, thank you very much for your time and all the best on May the 2nd.
Thank you, sir.
Well, there you have it. We have heard now from Manny Pacquiao. We've heard from Floyd Mayweather. Boy, what a day it's been. Give me your final thoughts on what you've heard today, Kieran.
Well, it's just kind of interesting to see that it's finally happened. All this build-up, all this anticipation, and now it's happened. They've met. They won't see each other again until fight week. We'll all scatter and we'll get ready for the big fight itself. It's very interesting to see the contrast. We knew they have contrasting personalities,
right?
But to see the contrast. Floyd very happy to talk at length, very confident. Manny just very quiet, not a guy who likes to talk a lot.
And you know, the interesting thing for me, when you heard Floyd Mayweather say, hey, this is a fight I wanted. This fight happened because I wanted. I always go back to what Bob Arum said at the dais. Well, we all have our own opinions. you know, if Bob Arum was there, he would probably beg to differ. But to me, that's what I took away from that.
Even Manny, too. I asked him, so, you know, was it you calling Floyd out? He goes, yeah, of course. It was me calling Floyd out. And, you know, they're not going to agree on anything.
Well, the only thing we have left is the fight. That's going to do it from here from the Nokia Theater in downtown Los Angeles. But Kieran Mulvaney, I'm Brian Custer. Folks, it is Floyd Mayweather versus Manny Pacquiao. It comes your way May 2nd at the MGM Grand in Las Vegas. You can see it on pay-per-view. Until then, we'll see you the week of the fight.